Let's go to Josh from Virginia. How are you doing, Josh?
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Doing well. Hey, what can we do for you?
So I'm an atheist for about a year and a half now, but my parents are still really religious, so theists. And we've been like, at first, you know, it was like the big fight and all, but we got past that. It's like, we just don't talk about it anymore. But now, like the whole COVID thing and everything, you know, going on, like, and I go to college, so George Mason, you know, Virginia. And so the thing is, like, my parents are all like, you know, anti-vax, very anti-vax. And so, like, I just don't talk to them about that. But, like, I don't know where to, like, because, like, they don't even speak English. Like, they speak Spanish. And it's like, I can't even give them the information. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Oh, I hear you. Do you mind if I ask, do you speak fluent Spanish or just kind of functional from what you've learned at home or?
Yeah, it's fluent enough. Yeah, I speak good Spanish. I mean, I was raised
fluent, fluent slash functional maybe. But yeah, no, that's the thing when it gets to the super scientific stuff. You know, if there isn't even a baseline for you to speak knowledgeably about biology in Spanish, then it's very hard to explain concepts about biology in Spanish if you don't know the words to use.
Yeah.
And that's something you wouldn't learn unless you're at a collegiate level. Yeah.
So are you still, you're in college, but you're still living with your parents, right?
Yeah, and that's the thing too. I've been like, I want to like move out, and I have the money, but it's like I need to stay with them because I need to finish college. You know?
No, right? Yeah. I mean, what's happening is like you're bringing me back to my younger days when I lived with family that I disagreed with, and my parents spoke fluent English, but it wasn't their primary language either. So this is kind of resonating with me a little, and I suppose like how. Is it like a really big important part of your family that you all agree on these same views on religion and science? Like, do they make a big deal out of it, or is it kind of something that they can hold aside for the sake of keeping the peace in the house?
They do make it a big thing, but I try to manage it and try to like wash the surface. You know what I'm saying? So like when I get home, like they'll be like listening to like preachers or like people on YouTube, like telling them crazy stuff about vaccines and Bill Gates and all this crazy stuff. It's just like,
yeah.
And then like they go to church, you know, it's like, it's just really hard. I don't know where to go from this.
And that's, one thing that you may have to be under the very realistic possibility that to them, you're always going to be the kid. Like, no matter how educated you get, no matter how much of a grown-up you are, there are a lot of family structures where there's a very strong feeling of the kid must never educate the parent. And they're never, you know, and I'm just saying, I can't say this for your case specifically, but these kind of parents will never turn around on a position because their kids, in fact, you might have the backfire effect here, where if you push on something strongly enough, just because it came from you, that's more reason that they're not going to buy into it. It sounds harsh, but that's the way they are sometimes. So like the next question after convincing them is somehow coexisting with them. How possible is that?
Yeah, that's the thing is like, yeah, I'm on the process of trying to like move out, but I don't know if I can, because it's just a crazy world. Like I don't know what to do right now, honestly.
But, no, I get it. There's a lot of things that are up in the air in the world right now. It's hard to make any sort of life plans whatsoever. So,
yeah.
So okay. So yeah, if you're, so
I'm like,
go ahead, please. I interrupted you. Go ahead.
I was talking over you. Yeah. I guess so. Like with my mom, like I did have one time. We talked about a lot of stuff. And I it was a nice way because like me and my dad, like he gets very like aggressive and stuff. So like, and my mom can be much easier to talk to, right? So one time I did talk to my mom, and I in a nice way, I pointed out like the things that are so obvious or like so like some common fallacy that, and just using like against them to show just to show her, and she like sees it, like she has like in those aha moments, but she doesn't want to budge. And then when she gets like offensive about it, like, and then we like go at it, and then like, and then at the end of that, like, that's when I stopped talking to her about the whole vaccine, because after that, she just pretty much at the end, what she said was, oh, so you're saying that the information that I'm getting are some stupid people, so you're calling me stupid. And I'm like, no, that is not how it is.
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not at all. And I mean, you know, depending on the kind of information that people get and who they choose to trust, it's not a reflection on them being stupid. I mean, some of these things are very convincing if you don't have good information otherwise, you know, and even if you do have good information otherwise, a lot of these are still presented in a very, very convincing, heart-touching way that it has nothing to do with intelligence at all. You're going to find very intelligent people on both sides. It's just, you know, now my big question is, are you able to make good decisions for yourself, about yourself, despite what they believe? Like, are you able to make the choice to be vaccinated yourself for healthcare decisions on your own?
Right. So that's exactly. So I'm already vaccinated. I've been vaccinated.
Okay.
I got it as soon as I could. Because I understand good. The science and I know what's going on. I understand. I can see the other side too. But and so that's the latest thing that's been coming up. Her saying, oh, are you, because school's right around the corner, like in 2 weeks. And she's like, oh, are you going to go back to school? Or are you going to get vaccinated? She's all asking like these things. I'm just like, I just keep like, honestly, like I just don't even stay in the house. Like I go to the gym, I go to work, and I try to leave the house.
Yeah.
Structures like that, I mean, it's just the reality that us kids, we're never going to convince our parents of anything that they don't want to hear from us.
It sucks,
but yeah, please, Martin.
Yeah. If I can just chime in at the end there, Puck is absolutely correct that, parents are bad at learning things from their children. And that's funny because parents will also say that their kids know way more about their smartphones than they ever could. So which is it, parents? But in all seriousness,
yeah.
You know what I mean though? My kid will figure it out. Oh, my kid's an idiot. Like, yeah. which is it? which do you want? Because that's a Schrodinger's child you have there. They're both simultaneously an idiot.
I helped them fix the Wi-Fi.
Yep.
I helped them fix the Wi-Fi, and that's something that I do often. Like, it's just something simple.
Yeah, and then they assume that they know about the 5G chip. Actually, I don't know if you mentioned that your parents believe in the chip or not.
Yeah,
they
conspiracy. At some point, they did believe in that.
Exactly. The thing, too, is I think the best way to have this conversation, if you were to ever have it, would probably be wait until you live somewhere else. Given that you don't want to compromise your home life, you want to make sure you get through college, I assume, in a timely manner. And unfortunately, biting the bullet is probably what's best for you at this point, if you're asking for my two cents. But when you do go to have that conversation, remind them what they once believed about the same topic and try to contrast it with what they believe now and ask them what changed. And this gets into, oh boy, truth wanted. This gets into street epistemology, where it's best to have these conversations by asking asking questions. And that's the thing too, former / current edgelords such as myself are really good at asking loaded questions. And what you have to do is you have to make sure you unload the question first. Don't hand somebody a loaded gun question, if you will. Instead, ask them a genuine question that you genuinely want to know the answer to and make sure that you present it in a way that like, hey, like, can we talk about this? Not in I need to reprimand you or I need to teach you something, but in like a, hey, I'd like to learn what you know about this because maybe I'm missing something. Yeah. And so again, those street epistemology conversations are really important. But again, in regard to your housing situation, I would give you the utmost caution to make sure you don't create a hostile home environment for yourself by causing somebody else to create it through, you know, being provoked with. And I don't want to make it sound like it would be your fault if that happened. Of course, it wouldn't be. But you can still make sure that you set yourself up for success, even if they aren't doing that for themselves, I guess is what I'll say. And that's the difference between being a kid and an adult, folks. Cut your losses.
The only other thing I'd add to that is, Josh, please keep us informed about what's going on. If you'd like to, you can email us truth@atheist-community.org. Look us up on Discord or in our Facebook fan group. Keep talking with us. I'd kind of like to know what decisions you've made and how you're doing with them. All right.
Yeah. So for finishing school, I can finish. Within less, like about in a year or maybe half a year. But the thing is, I would have to go full time, and my parents don't have that money. I'm working a full time job, so like, it's really stretching, you know.
Yeah, well, we got to move on tonight, Josh. But please keep us informed. And if you hit us up on those groups, there's going to be other people there who can give you a lot of good, meaningful advice too, especially dealing with bilingual families like the ones we had. All right. So thank you very much for giving us a call tonight.
Thank you.
And keep in touch with us.